everybody, and welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to be showing you how to crochet the puff V-stitch. The puff V-stitch is a very simple one row repeat, so it's super easy when you get going and makes for the most fantastic fully reversible scarves and blankets. So without any further ado, let's leap straight into the tutorial. To begin, pop a slip knot on your hook. Now the pattern multiple for the puff V stitch is 4 plus 2. Now all that means is you're going to chain in multiples of 4, 4, 4 for as wide as you want your project to be, then add 2 more chains at the very end. Now I'm just going to be making a small sample today, so I'm going to go ahead and chain 22. For row one, we're going to be working into the third chain from the hook. Now this loop on your hook does not count as anything. You only want to count your completed chains hanging down below. So we're going to skip the first two, 1, 2, and into this third chain, place a single crochet. Chain 1, skip a chain, single crochet in the next. Chain one, skip a chain, single crochet in the next. You're going to repeat this all the way down the row. Chain one, skip one, single crochet in the next. You'll be left with one remaining chain at the very end. Don't panic, we'll deal with that when we get there. So I'm approaching the very end here, just popping in a single crochet, and you can see there's no room for another chain one, skip one, because we have just one chain left. So in that very last chain, do not chain. Instead, pop a single crochet immediately in, straight after that last single crochet you just did. So you'll be ending with 2 single crochet stitches next to each other. For row two is the sort of setup row for the puff V stitches. It's a little bit fiddly, but bear with it because after we've got through row two, it's plain sailing from that point. So for row two, chain 3 and turn. Now we're going to skip the 2 single crochet below and we're going to work into this chain one space after them. And into that chain one space, we're going to work our first puff V stitch. Now the trick to a puff stitch is to keep it loose and to keep it tall. That way you get nice airy puff stitches. Now depending on your yarn, you may want to do more or less yarn overs than I'm going to show you in this. That's absolutely fine. You get your puff stitches to the fatness that you like your puffs to be. But for mine, I like to yarn over 4 times before completing the puff. So I'll show you exactly how to do that now. So working into this chain one space, skipping those 2 single crochet, you're going to yarn over, pop your hook into that chain one space and draw up a loop. Then pull it up nice and tall. We're going to repeat that motion 3 more times. Yarn over, go into that chain one space, pull up a loop and keep it nice and tall. Yarn over, go back into that chain one space and pull up a loop, pull it up tall. And then one more time, yarn over, go into that space, pull it up and pull it up tall. You will have 9 loops on your hook. Now we're going to yarn over and pull through all 9 of those loops. Now to make life a little bit easier for yourself, rotate your hook so it is facing down. That way it's less likely to catch on all these loops as you go through. And we're going to pull this working yarn through all 9 loops on your hook, just straight through everything. So all those loops you made and that original loop on your hook. Then to secure your puff stitch, chain 1 to lock it into place. That's your first puff stitch complete. Should be nice and fat and squishy. Then chain 1, and we're going to repeat that puff stitch back into the same chain 1 space. So yarn over, pull up a nice tall loop 4 times. That's 1. That's 2. That's 3. And that's 4. Once you have all your loops on your hook, yarn over, rotate your hook down and pull through all the loops on your hook. Then chain 1 to lock it into place. So your puff V stitch consists of puff stitch, chain 1, puff stitch. The chain 1s that we lock the puff into place with do not count as that middle chain. They are part of the puff stitch itself. So puff, chain 1, puff. That's your puff V stitch. Now we're going to repeat this little section all the way down, but we're going to skip 2 single crochets and that chain 1 in between before we do the next one. If you put your puffs in all the chain 1 spaces, your work is going to bow out and it's not going to lie flat. So this is the careful bit of this pattern. So skip 2 single crochets, they're easier to spot than the chain 1 spaces. 1, 2, and then work into the chain 1 space after those 2 single crochet. So skip, skip, and work your next puff V stitch into the chain 1 space after that. My first puff stitch, chain 1, and repeat. So repeat this down the line, skip 2 single crochet and work your puff V stitch into the chain 1 space after those 2 skip stitches. Once you've completed your final puff V stitch of the row and you have no more space to work anymore into this very end single crochet here, you may need to rotate around slightly to see it. We're going to pop a double crochet stitch in there to finish. Take a moment to check that your work is lying flat. If you are bowing out like this, just double check you've been skipping 2 single crochet and you haven't accidentally tried to crush in 1 more. These are quite fat stitches, and if you're not careful with this initial count, you will get a sort of arching like this. Once you're happy, we can move on to the much, much easier row three. So row three is the pattern repeat row. All that means is this next row we're going to do is the row you repeat over and over and over until your project is the length that you want it to be. So for row three, we're going to chain three and turn. It is much, much easier from this point on. Now we're going to work our puff V stitches again, but this time we're going to work them into the chain one space in between the sets of puffs on the row below. Much, much easier to spot. They all stack up in line with each other and form nice, clear columns. So spot your chain one space in between the two puffs below, and in there we're going to work a puff V stitch. So puff, chain one, puff, all into the same chain one space. Continue this into the top of all the puffs from the row below. Be careful not to work into the sides. You only want to go right in between the two puffs from the row below. Once you've finished your last set of puff stitches, you'll have the same amount all stacked neatly on top of each other as you did in the row below. We're going to end with a double crochet, but not into the top of the turning chain as you traditionally would. We're going to end with that double crochet in the chain three space that's created at the end. So just yarn over and pop your hook into that space instead. You can go into the top of the turning chain if you prefer, but when you're working with puff stitches, you want there to be a bit of room. And so by working into the space, it gives a much straighter edge than it would if you were picking out that top chain. So to continue the pattern, you would simply repeat what we just did in row three. We'll do a quick recap. So chain three, turn, work your puff V stitches into the chain one space of your puff V stitches of the row below. Then when you've finished your final puff V stitch of the row, end with a double crochet into the chain three space to finish off. Once your project is the length you want it to be and you have finished your final stitch of the row, you would chain one, snip your yarn, leaving an end to weave in, pull it up and out, and then pull that chain one tight, ready to weave in. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial on the puff V stitch. If you found it helpful, please do give me a thumbs up. And until next time, happy crocheting. Bye.